Number 15, Burger King food letters. The last thing you want in your Burger King burger is someone's food fungus.
Oh, hello there. Hi. Welcome to my land. Summer is now officially halfway over, and I haven't done really anything at all this summer. I mean, all I've really done this summer is just add more stupid stuff to my room. I mean, I've been building onto my computer here, this fine thing. I bought a chalice. I did that for a reason. I had more amoebers over there. Look at those. Look at these freaking things. Do you see these right here? I have almost all of them. All the Smash Bros. Ones. This is insane. I own a freaking Keyblade now. I did that for a reason.
Keyblade.
Darkness. Darkness.
Keyblade.
Keyblade?
Hot. Darkness. The Keyblade.
Keyblade.
Darkness.
Keyblades have hearts.
Heart.
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 These are all things that don't really, these don't matter in the end. These things are just purchases, and then I'm just gonna buy them, they sit in my room somewhere, and then all of a sudden, that's it, they're just part of my room. I need to figure out to do something, and maybe I should review some movies or something. Write stuff on the internet or something. Make music. I don't know, I need to do something. We need to go back in time to back to simpler times. So maybe we can take something from those simpler moments in life and turn to something new so we can make something special out of it. I know exactly how we're gonna do it. Let's go. So I'm here in my movie collection room area that me and my family like to add upon here and there. We have a lot of movies, see if you can tell. There's a lot of weird movies in here. There's a lot of movies in here that I haven't really seen myself. I mean, let's just pull a few, you know? What is this? Spy? Starring Melissa McCarthy, Jason Statham, Rose Byrne, and Jude Law? Good lord. Girl, comma, Interrupted. With Winona Ryder and Angelina Jolie. Won a 1999 Academy Award. Never heard of it. Stuck on You. Matt Damon and Greg Kinnear. From the guys who brought you There's Something About Mary. Never heard a good one. Just look at Matt Damon's face here. Look at him. The point is, there's a lot of movies in here that I haven't seen, but there are a good amount of movies in here that I have seen. Some of them I watched a lot. And one of those movies is this one right here. You're gonna be surprised by this one. Herbie's Fully Loaded. I know what you're thinking. Mr. Doomarachi. Herbie? Really? Herbie, me and him, man, we went together like bread and bread and the thing, you know?
But go, you know the thing.
I haven't watched this movie in probably a good couple decade or so. So I think it's finally high time I sit back and I watch it. You know, something interesting about this movie is that I love this movie for another reason. It was something that was in the special features. For some reason, when I was young, I would watch this movie a lot, but I would always go to the special features, and there was always this short, like, 15-minute or so documentary on just, like, some old Volkswagen parade where they decorated cars and all that stuff, and they drove down streets, and people would be like, oh, look at that, yeah, it's a cool decorated Volkswagen right there and all this stuff. It's on this disc. So I'm gonna pop this in, and I'm really excited to see the old documentary again. I haven't seen it in around a decade or so. So I'm really excited to have the memories just flood back and seeing all those interesting cars that I used to watch a lot. So let's go do it. This menu right here, I've seen this menu a good couple hundred times. I'm not entirely sure, I couldn't count when I was a kid. But here it is. The screen that I saw a lot when I was younger. So you know what? Before I actually watch the movie, I need to see this documentary first. So it has to be in the bonus features, right? Let's go take a look at it real quick. I think I'm starting to see a problem here. It's not there.
What the hell's going on here? Where is it?
It was on this disc. I watched it a lot when I was a kid. There's no way my dumb mind could come up with something this weird. Okay, maybe it has to be in Music and More. I mean, that would make sense, right? Does someone want to explain to me why there's an entire sub-menu for just a music video? I know it existed. I watched it. I watched it many times. There's no way this thing just stopped existing. What's going on here? I'm not crazy. I've seen this documentary way too many times. More times than I should be proud of. But you know what? I know it existed, and I know it was on this damn disc. We're gonna have to do some research. Okay, so after doing some research, The Love Bug Parade of 1969. That is what I watched a long time ago when I was younger. It exists. This video that you're watching right now is exactly what I watched a long time ago. I don't know what entranced me so much about this, but I loved it. I loved it so much. Little shout out to Jim Douglas, the man who uploaded that video onto the internet, because I cannot find this video anywhere else. And it took me a little while to finally find out where I could find it. Without you uploading this thing to the internet, I would have legit thought I had gone crazy. But it really makes you wonder, why was it not on the disc? I'm being extremely 100% serious when I say that Love Bug Parade, that 12, 13 minute long video, it was on the Herbie's Fully Loaded DVD, but now it's not. If you haven't figured it out by the title of the video, we are gonna be exploring the Mandela effect. It's absolutely terrifying and really scary when you actually encounter examples like this in your actual life. Once I do research on it, I'm like, oh my gosh, can't believe it's always like this and that. But everyone felt this way. This was something personal. This was something that I know for a fact that it was on there, and only I know, and my sister knows too, but only me and my sister know that it was on this disc, but now it's not. The Mandela effect, if you haven't, you know, Googled it already, it's basically this weird psychic, weird otherworldly dimensional phenomenon where you think that one thing happened or a certain thing was like this, but in reality, it was like something else. It says that this is how the multiverse works, is that our universe is gonna collide with another universe, and once we do collide with that universe, something small or changes will happen. Like how the Herbie's Fully Loaded disc did have that documentary on it, but now it doesn't. There are a ton of examples of this Mandela. One that really messed me up here is Looney Tunes. It's spelled like tunes, as in like radio tuning and all that stuff, but not tunes as in cartoons. It doesn't even make sense. Like, why is it Looney Tunes? Like, it should be tunes, and like as in cartoon. Curious George. He's swinging around the jungle in his tail or whatever with the man in yellow hat, you know, swinging around his tail. He never even had a tail. He never had a tail. He never had a goddamn tail. Ow, damn it. I have right here the Curious George video game on the Xbox, original Xbox. All right, this was official movie merchandise from Namco. The same people that made Pac-Man. He has no tail. He has no tail. He has no tail, look. No tail! Game of the year, 3 years in a row, no tail. Febreze? Oh, it has one E. Febreze? Febreze? Febreze! As in, it's a breeze. A breeze comes through the window. Breeze, not brez, breeze. What? Skechers? Skeechers! Skeechers! It's Skechers! Skechers! Where is the T? It's Skeechers! Where is the T? The shoes we all wore when we were like f***ing 10 years old. Skechers! Not Skeechers! We all love Pikachu. Everyone's favorite Pokemon for some god-known reason. Remember that tail? Wrong tail. It doesn't have a black spot at the end of its tail. That's bullshit. You see this f***er right here? You see that? There's no red stuff on the end of his tail. Look at this innocent, perfect little electric rat, whatever the f*** this thing is. It has no red, black stuff on the end of its tail. Why? Let's get into movies. Let's get into movies real quick. All of Star Wars Episode 5, Empire Strikes Back. It's always called Empire by the fans. We all remember the classic line,
Luke, I am your father.
But guess what? It was always just,
no, I am your father.
No sir, I watched a lot of Star Wars when I was younger. I was a loser back then, okay? I had no friends, I watched a lot of Star Wars.
I know for a freaking fact that he said Luke before that. I know he did. I remember it. Snow White and the Seven Dwarves. We all remember the classic line, mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all? Guess what? It's just...
Magic mirror on the wall, who is the fairest one of all?
Mirror, mirror on the wall, because he wants to rhyme with it. Why is it magic? It just doesn't roll off the tongue. Forrest Gump is pretty much a perfect movie in every sense of the word. We all know the one line that everyone loves to quote, because God knows that almost no one else quotes anything else from that movie. We all know the famous line, life is like a box of chocolate, but no.
My mom always said, life was like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get.
Nah. The last one, the one that sets everyone ablaze, the one that everyone gets so mad over, the Berenstain Bears. You've probably heard this one multiple times before, but no matter how many times I explain it, no matter how many times I see it, it always messes with me. It's the Berenstain Bears. We all know, we've read those books when we were younger. We've read them. They forced us to read these books. They forced me to read so many of these damn books when I was younger. I read that title so many times, the Berenstain Bears. I read it. I seen that goddamn stupid freaking logo shit so many times when I was younger. I know for a fact it said Berenstain. Now all of a sudden you want to say to me that it's Berenstain? What? You see, this is exactly what this is. This is the multiverse right here, people. If you don't believe in a multiverse now, you best believe it, because there are an infinite amount of universes. I, for one, believe in the multiverse theory. This is proof. The Mandela effect is proof right here, folks, okay? There's an infinite amount of universe with an infinite amount of changes. I can't just sit here and just do nothing about this, all right? A bunch of people believe in this Mandela effect stuff, and you should too. I need to get out there, and I need to start a movement, go to DC, do stuff. I need to go do that. I'm gonna go do that right now. Let's do it. Okay, guys, so I'm just gonna start packing my stuff here. I have all my bags right here. I'm gonna go get some plane tickets here and stuff. I'm gonna go right to DC, right in front of the White House, and we're gonna do some stuff, okay? That's kind of funny. I thought my door knocked for a second. I live alone. There should be no reason my door... Oh. Who is it? Now, I should open the door, but it's kind of scary, so I'm gonna stay in here. I've been looking for you for a long time. I had to freshen up. Okay. Let's talk to this guy. Okay. Who are you? And what do you want?
Well, I'm you.
Well, no you aren't. I'm me.
Well, yes, but I'm you from an alternate universe.
Okay, well, that makes sense.
Do you wish for me to explain?
What do you think, dumbass?
Okay, I come from a universe where technology is vastly ahead of your current time. The world is run by a mega corporation type of deal, where basically they run and control everything.
How?
Isn't there like antitrust laws and no monopoly rules and all that stuff in your universe or something?
No, those all got removed. It was one big grand operation from the company. This company being a little thing called LG.
LG? LG makes awesome electronics here.
Except for their phones, they mostly suck.
Well, that's interesting, because LG, in my universe, makes the most powerful and dangerous technology in the entire universe. How did you even get here with this? What is that? This is quantum power. This single device right here carries more power and more energy than your entire military infrastructure right now.
Okay, scary. What does it even do?
This single device right here allows you to traverse any universe you want. Around a year ago, I worked for LG, and they kept us all in the dark about this device and what it can do. They said it was going to be the future. It was going to be the grandest thing they've ever created. I had to know what it was. I had to know. I saved up a lot of money, close, and I got, you know, I had to make shady deals. I had to talk to very sketchy people to get everything I needed, and I broke into the facility holding this device. I had to know what it was. I had to. But I really regret being that curious. Why?
Well, this device is clearly a prototype, but as you can see, it works. I'm here. But it's lacking a very, very crucial feature.
What's that? A way back home.
What? It doesn't have a way back to your original dimension. You basically just go in here and you just go to some random dimension. It's very difficult to choose a specific one, but once you go to that dimension, there's no way back. At least nothing that I can figure out yet.
Well, that was kind of dumb, wasn't it?
I was in a rush. I had no idea what this was. I needed to know what it was. You try going to the most high-tech secret laboratory of all time and go try to find the most powerful technology they are holding in there, and you get out of that facility alive with the device.
Can I see it? Please be careful. It's out of power. Traveling between universes and stuff takes a great deal of energy. Luckily, this battery here is self-renewing, so it basically charges itself. But this thing right here, it carries enough energy about around three entire Earths in this timeline.
A battery that powerful would take absolutely years upon years.
Well, again, the power source here is self-renewing, so it basically charges itself. It takes around 3 whole months just to fully charge to use it, you know?
Well, how long have you been here?
Well, you know, I live alone, so, I mean, you can stay here until you're able to jump again.
Yeah, that's the issue.
Oh boy. You see, two of the same beings cannot exist within the same universe. It causes paradoxes and issues. A certain paradox will most definitely and will definitely cause the entire universe and multiverse to basically collapse and everything will be gone.
Yeah. Oof. That sounds real bad. What's gonna happen?
Well, things will just start falling apart, and it's just not a good thing to happen. And you know, we don't want that to happen now, so we have to do something about it.
But what's the issue?
Well, one of us has to go. Two of us can't be here. One of us needs to not be here.
Well, sounds like we need to get you out of here faster.
The battery still needs to charge. It's going to still take a while.
Was there any way to charge it faster?
This plan doesn't have the elements needed. Or at least they haven't discovered it yet.
Christ. Okay, then how do we solve this?
I have to go back. Even it means eliminating you.
You're gonna kill me?
I'm sorry.
How do you even know it's gonna work?
It has before.
What does that mean?
How many universes do you think I've been through? You think this is my first time? No. This is my... I don't even know anymore. I jumped across hundreds upon hundreds upon hundreds of universes, searching for my way back. It's basically just clockwork for me at this point. I go to a new universe, I see if it's the right one. If not, I have to go find my copy, my equal. I have to eliminate them. And then I jump to the next one.
You're insane.
I'm a victim. I've been thrust
into a world of technology and incredible sciences developed by a company who would have destroyed the entire multiverse if I decided not to intervene. I didn't know what it was, but I'm pretty sure that was Destiny who did that for me. And you think killing me is gonna bring you back to your home? Shut up. Shooting me with that gun right there is gonna bring you right back home, that dystopian hellscape you're from? Shut up! What was that? It's beginning. The collapse. Right. What's all this then? Is that me?
Yeah, that's us.
Why the f*** am I here? How's that middle doing a gig, you f***? Kids?
Shut up, mophead.
F*** you, Vision. Do you realize what is happening here?
No. Why is there a very badly voiced British rock star version of me right here?
Universes are starting to collapse. Versions of ourselves are going to start popping up all over the place.
Okay, well, shouldn't we talk about who lives and dies here?
My gun will do the talking.
Well, this is bullshit!
Shut up. This is how it is.
Alright, well, this is interesting and all, but, I think I hear something coming out of that door that I just came out of.
What the f*** are you?
What is that? I have no clue what's happening anymore. I'm lost. Hey all, Rachi here. Whoa, wait, why? There's a lot of me's in here. I really don't know what's going on here, but hey, I have an Infinity Gauntlet!
Jesus! Oh! Why?
Screw you, man! Oh.
Yeah, well, I'm done playing games. This ends now.
I don't want to hurt you. Who are you?
You're not gonna hurt me with anything. What do you have to use? Your Keyblade?
Me?
Okay, that's it. I'm killing everyone in this room right now.
Not if we kill you first.
What?
All right, stop right there.
Are you serious?
If you stop firing, I'm gonna stop firing. Okay, guys, let's just take this calmly.
Yeah, will you want me?
Oh, gosh.
Yes, let's go!
Oh, fuck.
Keep jumping across different universes again and again and again. If that's a risk, I will take it.
Where is it?
What?
Where is the device?
I don't know.
Where is it?
I don't have it.
God damn you! You did something with the goddamn device! Where is it?
You had it.
Ugh. God damn you!
Doesn't matter now.
Even as we speak, versions of us are appearing all over the damn place. Even if I kill you now, I can't stop all of them. This is all your fault! If you would have stayed there and let me kill you, I would have been out of here, the universe wouldn't be collapsing, and I would have had another chance to get back home. But no, you had to wreck it!
Well, I just guess I have the solution right here.
That's just a goddamn toy! What is wrong with you? This isn't a damn movie!
You know, I really don't know what life is anymore. But you know what? Let's find out together.
Dear Journal, it's been a long time since I updated this, but I think it's time I finally did. These past few months have been absolute insanity, and I don't really know how to put it into words, but I have to try. I should really start at the beginning, shouldn't I? I remember just being thrusted into a big white flash, and I was just so confused on what happened, but I was outside. How did I get outside? I was outside my house, I think? It was surely my house. I looked at it, and I was so confused. How did I get out here? I looked around, and it was my yard. The sky was the same. Nothing was different. It was just my house. But how did I get outside? I needed to do some more investigating. I decided to go with my porch, and my porch was the same, my doors were the same, my doorbell was the same, but the one thing that really wasn't the same was that my doors were unlocked. I never leave my doors unlocked. What happened? They're always locked. But I decided to go inside anyways. I went downstairs, and I noticed that there was a bunch of people just arguing at each other. They all looked like me. One with a top hat, one with a submachine gun, and one with a giant key? That was weird. But one thing that really piqued my interest was I heard a faint buzzing on a table over there. I don't know what entranced me about it, but I heard that buzzing and I just needed to get to it. It was like something was just drawing me there. I decided to not so sneakily, stealthily, whatever, snuck over there. And I don't know how no one saw me, but I guess they were just so interested in each other that they didn't even bother to notice me. And I picked up the thing, and it was a phone. It wasn't on, but it was a phone. I like stealing stuff sometimes, but why did I want this? But I know I had to hide because that one guy had a gun and I didn't want him shooting me, so I hid in the bathroom and I turned the light on and I locked the door. And I just needed to know what this phone was. The bathroom was the same, but you know, that was pretty weird. But the phone. The phone all of a sudden came on. Like, it had power. I don't know what I did, but it had power now. But I decided to fiddle around with it for some reason. I don't know why I chose to, and so eventually I pushed a button, and everything would turn to yellow. Why was it yellow? What happened? But I decided to wait until these guys outside were done yelling at each other, waiting for them to leave or something. I didn't want to get hurt. I waited, and I waited, and I waited, until eventually gunfire started happening. These people had guns! That's insane! But eventually the gunfire stopped, and I waited for them to leave, until a big flash happened again. Why does this keep happening? I was so confused about it, but the yellow was gone. Was I shielded or something? It's kind of a fantasy thought, but the yellow was gone after that flash, so maybe I was shielded from something. And I decided to listen through the door, but there was nothing. It was just pure quiet. I need to know what was happening out there, but I was so skeptical whether I should or not. But I know I had to leave this place eventually. I decided to open the door, and they were gone. There was no one out here, except for him. There was just him on the ground. He was just leaning against the wall, and he looked motionless, with a big thing on his hand. And he was dead. He had a giant key. I don't know why he had a giant key, but it was pretty cool. But I kept looking more and more at him, and we looked almost exactly the same. His hair was just on a different side, and he had glasses, but I thought, what should I do with him? I'm the only one here now. Where did everyone go? Why did his phone bring me here? He must have did something to get rid of all those other people, and it must have cost him his life. But I don't know. I decided to look at him once more. Something just, this idea just flew over my mind. But his glasses. What was so special about his glasses? I had to put them on, and when I did, it just flooded into my brain. I know exactly what I had to do. I flipped my hair over. I just had to see something. I was him. I looked exactly like him. That's with different shirt and pants, but I was him. We looked so similar. He was me and I was him now. It was amazing. I decided to go inside of his room, take a look at it, and well, it looks almost exactly like my room. Just a little bit messier, but I can do it. And so I decided right there that I should take over his life. I don't know why I chose to do it, but I didn't think I was gonna get back home anyways, but now I'm here, I took over his life, and I decided to bury him outside. It was kind of weird burying yourself, but it's kind of a life experience everyone should have in my point of view. But now I just have to take over his life. It's going pretty well. It's been 3 months since that incident happened, but the phone came back on one day, and I decided not to touch it. I just don't want anything more to do with that phone. It's pretty weird being someone else in their own universe, but no one noticed it, so that's pretty good. It's kind of a learning curve, but everyone thought I was kind of crazy for a while, but everyone's accepted it, and now I pretty much know everyone that he knew. So, Journal, I'm going to finish you off with this. Life is insane, and no matter what universe you're in, always make the most out of it.
Well, let's get to work.
Hey everyone, Doomarachi here. Right, I'm just going to quickly say thank you so much for watching this video. If you watched all of it, you're truly an amazing person, and I know this Mandela Effect Part 2, whatever video, took forever to come out, and I just had to refilm all of it, and I decided to get it all done back-to-back without stopping, so it's finally done. This took a very long time to make, and I greatly appreciate it if you watched all of it. If you enjoyed the video, absolutely please leave a like and a comment. Every ounce of feedback, even if it's negative, is worth it, and it means a lot to me because it helps me improve the channel, and I want to get this channel back on track. I want to make great videos, great content for you people, and so absolutely feedback. But again, thank you so much for watching this video. I know this took a while to come out, but it's finally here, it's done. I'm gonna end the video now because I don't want to keep talking and waste your time, but thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate you, and God bless, and have yourself a damn good one. Thank you.